What did you make of this step? I mean, it seems a long time coming.
Yes, I mean, for a space reporter like myself, you have to understand the real surreal nature of watching this rocket launch. I think I've been covering this rocket since I started reporting on space 8 years ago. But yes, it finally launched. There were some moments during the countdown where we were unsure if it was actually going to take off last night or actually this morning, but it finally did, and it was a sight to behold.
I felt what you felt, Loren. I felt the rumble of the rocket go into the Earth's atmosphere, right? I completely get what you're saying. There is a serious point to all of this, of course. There is a mission here. Talk to us about what Orion is going to be doing for the next 25 days, the capsule itself. I think we have a map of the mission that it's conducting.
Right. So first and foremost, this is a test flight, right? The main objective of Artemis 1 was to debut the massive new rocket, the Space Launch System, and the Orion crew capsule together on a flight and show that they can actually send a mission around the moon safely and return it home to Earth. So an hour and a half after launch this morning, I keep trying to say last night, but it was this morning, they conducted something known as a translunar injection burn, which sent it on its trajectory to the moon. So right now it's on its way to the moon. And soon in the next week or so, it will insert itself into lunar orbit. It'll stay there for about a week. Then it will come back home and it will attempt to splash down in the Pacific Ocean intact with its heat shield reaching temperatures of up to 5,000 degrees Fahrenheit. And that's going to be a big test as well, because, you know, we can send people to space, but we got to take them home safely. And just to be clear, there was nobody on this flight. This was just a test to see that we could actually send this hardware into space safely.
Loren, 30 seconds. Frustrating for many, Artemis 2, no matter what, won't go up for another couple of years.
Yes, that is kind of the downside of this program. It's going to take a lot between this mission and that and the next one. NASA is still targeting the first landing as early as 2025, but there's a lot of skepticism whether that's going to happen or not. So, yes, there is a lot of time between these missions, some things that critics have been quick to point out. But, you know, that it was a fantastic sight, so I'll definitely be, you know, patiently waiting for the next one.